how you doing? It's your girl Big T coming back to you for another review of Fantasia For Real. This is episode 4, and you guys will only have 4 more episodes after this. Okay, so let's dig right into it. The show opens up with Brian bringing in Fantasia's life coach to kind of talk to her about some of the things that she's been dealing with and going through right now. Because at the end of the last episode, if you remember, Fantasia was kind of feeling a little depressed, and she did mention that when she's unhappy and when things at home are going wrong and going awry, she doesn't work and stuff. So I think to keep her on track, Brian brought in the life coach, and basically the life coach told her everything that everybody else was telling her, you know. But sometimes you need a fresh face or somebody, you know, who wasn't really in the situation that you've been dealing with and going through to kind of give you a fresh eyes so that you can actually hear what is being said. Because if you got people who are all up in the mix telling you, you know, what you need to be doing and this needs to happen and that needs to happen, you're not really going to hear them because your judgment is clouded with them being, you know, already tied to this to the incident or the situation. So with the life coach coming in, there's no ties or anything. So Fantasia was able to clearly hear what she needed to do, you know, whether she was right about kicking Tini out and, you know, and staying strong and holding her ground while she's going through this situation, okay? So after talking with the life coach, Tini sends some flowers and a card to Fantasia. And I just thought that was a punk move right there. And I'm glad that Fantasia saw it too. And, you know, but she handled it really well. She was like, tell him, because he called. Like, to, I guess, to see if she got the card and everything, and wanted her to read the card out to the family. And she was like, no, tell him the card was for me. I got the card. Thank you. I apologize. You know, but he, my brother, he can come to me. If he need to talk about something, then let him do that. So I totally agree with how she handled that situation. 1 point for her. Okay, let's get moving. Next, Brian took her to New York, and they met with a new A&R rep. And I was very happy about this because at the end of the last episode, I really thought that she was going to consider leaving Jay Records, which would have been a bad move. Her career really would have ended after that because I don't know who else out there would have signed Fantasia. You know, somebody would have picked her up. I don't know who it would have been, but somebody would have picked her up, and it probably wouldn't have been somebody as good as Jay Records. I think Jay Records is good for artists like Fantasia, you know, who can bring them in and kind of envelop them and help them hone their skills and develop into an artist and make this a career, you know, not just a person who's, you know, trying to put out albums and get hit records every year or something. So, you know, I was really happy that she decided to stay. I'm glad that she switched A&R reps because, you know, they were with Larry. And Fantasia tried to call him out, but she really didn't call him out. I don't know if you guys caught it, but I put two and two together. When she was like, you know, I don't want to call nobody out and throw them underneath the bus or anything like that. But I just think that, some, you know, people, the record company's been dragging their feet and people have been busy with other things. And you're right. You're right. Fantasia called that. Larry's too busy working on Monica's stuff. Yep. Y'all didn't know. That's the same dude that was in Monica's show. Come on, people. Stay with me. So I'm glad that she switched and she got Keith. And I like Keith. He seems really cool. He did his homework. And like he told her, he was like, look, we're going to go forward and do what we need to do. Okay, so after that, she goes back to North Carolina because Grandma's in the building, who's also their pastor and everything. Grandma's called a family meeting to discuss everything that's going on and hopefully put an end to all this petty stuff that's going on. So she calls Tini, okay, and says, hey, Tini, I'm in town. We're going to have a family meeting. We need you here. Oh, yeah, Grandma, I'm going to be there. Now, let me just tell y'all something. Okay, I'm from North Carolina. I used to live in Winston-Salem, which is probably about 20 minutes from Greensboro, where Tini was staying, okay? And Charlotte, and I know where Charlotte is too. Okay, so Tini, it does not take 2.5 to 3 hours to get from Greensboro to Charlotte. And from what Grandma was saying, you didn't sound like you were really in Greensboro at the time. It sounded like you were 5 minutes around the corner. That's what it sounded like to me. Okay? So I thought it was very disrespectful of Teenie not to show up. I thought it was very disrespectful of Teenie not to answer any phone calls. Dude, you ain't got no place where you live in, so you got your phone on you. And I thought it was very disrespectful for him to not even call and say, hey, you know what? I'm not feeling it right now. I'm just not going to come. If that's how you wanted to roll, Teenie, you should have called and said that and let it be. Okay? So, whatever, you're just showing your immaturity again. That's 28-year-old, he's very immature, okay? You're not handling this situation right. But anyway, they do the meeting, and, you know, grandma gives it to him and lets them know, people, you need a rock like that. Do y'all have a rock like that in your family? I don't. You know, I would think that my mom would kind of be that spiritual rock in our family, but we don't really get together like that to, you know, discuss things and whatnot, but it is definitely something that I think is needed in every family. So much respect to grandma. She got the spirit in there on them. Yep, they didn't know about that. So that was really good. So after that meeting, finally Teenie ends up calling Fantasia. Now he's sitting out in the neighborhood, out probably a block down the street or whatever. Calls her to kind of get her vibe and see what's going on. Wants to come back home. And so he's like, we need to talk. He apologized a little bit on the phone. But then he was like, you know, yeah, I need to come and talk to you. But the reason why I can't stay mad at Teenie, and I think this is the reason why Fantasia puts up with a lot of his mess, is because when he was like, well, check it, I'm right around the corner, shorty. I'm perusing the neighborhood now, you know, I'll be there right in a minute. And she was like, Lord, am I gonna need some wine for this? And he was like, well, shorty, just pour me a glass too. I found that funny. I'm like, Teenie, you can't stay mad at him for too long. But Teenie comes in, sits down and talks with Fantasia. That was the best. He should win a freaking Oscar for that performance that he gave. Nothing but lies. Okay, he lied from the time he walked in that room and sat down to the time he bear hugged her and moved back in. I mean, he just... Okay, I'm trying to give Teenie the benefit of the doubt here. I'm trying to put some faith in him, but it's very, very hard. And I don't even know Teenie. If I don't trust Teenie, and if I can't believe that, I just don't know how Fantasia is feeling about it, okay? So, I'm glad I ain't got to deal with it. Hey, I can tell you, don't be jealous of people. You do not know what they are going through. But Teenie put on a good performance. He was real cocky in that meeting. Did y'all catch that? He was just, well, I just feel like, you know, y'all ain't supporting me the way I need to be. Fool! This ain't no freaking AA meeting. Get your tail up and get a job, okay? Talking about so I need some support. Boy, bye. Just boy, bye. That's all that is. Anyway, Fantasia goes to the studio, sitting with a manager, listening to some tracks that Keith, her new A&R director, gave her. And I think that song they were listening to, that's the one, Fantasia. That's the one. That sounded to me, well, we can hear a little bit of it. That sounded like a Fantasia song. So much props to Keith for giving her that track. I hope they record it, and I hope that is her new single that comes out when her album drops. You know what I'm saying? Let me see. I'm looking at my notes. Okay, so the show ends with Fantasia and Teenie's ex-girlfriend. Gotta give props to her, too. See, yeah, you may be the ex-girlfriend, but you still gotta be in the show. You know what I'm saying? So I like that. You know what I'm saying? I like that. But anyway, they're talking. Fantasia has agreed to let Teenie come back into the house. Teenie has said by the first of the year, which I think is January 2010, he's going to be out and on his own doing his thing. Okay? So I don't know if that really happens. Like I said, we got 4 more episodes to see what's going on down. And I really do pray. You know, I want to put my faith. I'm not putting my faith out there like that for Teenie. But, you know, If he makes it, congratulations. If he doesn't, Fantasia, we told you so. So you can't be mad, okay? So, but that was episode 4. We have 4 more episodes left. So you guys, stay tuned. The craziness has an end. I don't think 4 episodes is going to be enough to kind of put this, you know, where it can be settled. But I'm with you, Rico. Teenie has not changed, and he is not leaving that house. And like you said, yes, it is good to live off the fat of the lamb, especially somebody else's lamb. You know what I'm saying? Okay, so Anyway, that's all I have for now. I love you guys. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you think. Let me know how you feel about the situation and what's going to happen next. You predict it, okay? Because I'm all out of it. I'm just watching from this point on. All right? I'll talk to y'all later. This is your girl, Big T. I love you. God loves you. Jesus can save. And I'm out of here. Bye.